Quite an interesting last few hours. About 11:30 last night here in Santa Rosa, California. Out of nowhere, wind started circulating. I went outside as I heard my chime starting to go off, and I thought that was odd. There's winds, and all of a sudden, blue sparks came out of the sky. No lightning, just blue sparks. And at 1 o'clock in the morning, 60 fires, Napa, Sonoma, Santa Rosa, just hit everywhere.
Climate engineering, geoengineering, solar radiation management programs are an absolutely undeniable reality. The ongoing illegal climate intervention operations are decimating the biosphere. This includes further fueling catastrophic forest fires all over the globe. Those who ignore or deny what they can see with their own eyes, the profoundly altered aerosol sprayed skies, grid pattern skies on some days, with nothing on other days, are turning two blind eyes to the immense and ongoing climate engineering threat. Jet aircraft spray dispersions are often seen being turned on and off, which countless film captures prove is occurring in skies all over the world. We're not seeing condensation trails. Jet engines are not being turned on and off. We're seeing intentionally sprayed aerosol dispersions that are a primary aspect of geoengineering and solar radiation management. If jet aircraft are being used, in fact, for geoengineering and solar radiation management aerosol spraying operations, they must have nozzles, and indeed, they do. In addition to military tankers, commercial aircraft are being utilized in the ongoing geoengineering operations, though commercial carrier personnel do not appear to be in any way involved. Why aren't the climate scientists, like those in the National Weather Service and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administrations, speaking out? In addition to having no First Amendment protection, there is now an illegal federal gag order on all National Weather Service and all NOAA employees. Climate engineering programs are nothing short of weather warfare on innocent. Geoengineering is also destroying the ozone layer. And this is not conjecture, it's not theory, it's not speculation. Rather, it's verifiable fact. Though mainstream sources are still not acknowledging the climate engineering reality, the catastrophic truth can't be hidden much longer. How many mainstream media sources covered the severe ozone depletion story? Ozone depletion is also occurring all over the globe. Though this depletion is most profound over the polar regions, the impacts are, as already stated, global and getting worse by the day. The now extreme UV radiation is literally frying and killing trees. The damage is most visible where there is the most exposure to the sun. Different species have various levels of resistance to the rapidly increasing UV radiation levels, which includes UVC, the last band of UV radiation before X-ray. But the signs of the UV radiation damage are everywhere and easy to see for anyone that takes the time to notice. Rapidly increasing lightning is yet another firestorm factor that's directly connected to the climate engineering operations. The atmospheric saturation of electrically conductive materials greatly increases the static charge of the atmosphere and thus creates an easier pathway for cloud-to-ground lightning strikes. Though mainstream sources continue to blame increased lightning on planetary warming, the warming itself is not the primary causal factor for the lightning increase. Geoengineering is. The heavy metal particulate fallout from climate engineering operations is coating forests, homes, rooftops, and everything in between. One of the primary elements of this fallout is aluminum. Lab tests from around the globe prove this. Aluminum particulates or dust are an incendiary. What does this add up to? Climate engineering fallout is covering the forest foliage and everything else with an incendiary or flammable layer of extremely fine particulate dust. Radio frequency microwave transmissions are another aspect of the climate engineering assault that's fueling forest fires. These transmissions can and are heating the atmosphere and creating high pressure zones and stationary heat domes that accompany these high pressure domes. These transmissions are responsible for the creation of what has been termed the ridiculously resilient ridge that has consistently plagued the U.S. West Coast for nearly a decade. This completely engineered ridge of high pressure effectively cuts off the rain from the U.S. West. The climate engineers decide where it rains and where it won't. They now control the flow of precipitation and thus the flow of life. NDS and countless other sources correctly acknowledge that human activity is fueling wildfires. But what human activity are they not willing to say a word about? The climate engineering elephant in the room. And though all forms of human activity that alter Earth's energy balance and the biosphere as a whole must be considered forms of geoengineering, in regard to the rapidly increasing catastrophic forest fires, the intentional climate modification programs are by far, mathematically speaking, the single greatest causal factor.
You're talking on your mother. You're talking on your sister. You're talking on your mother. You're talking on your...